Subscribe to my channel and do not forget to press the bell icon. It's totally free.
Hello, welcome to JURIS Central online classes for law exams. Today I will be dealing with solved paper of DU LL.M entrance test 2014. In the previous session I had given you the test paper of 2015. Surprisingly, only one person attempted, although the video was watched over 1000 times. The name of the person is Irfan Ahmed. You did a great job, Irfan. I really appreciate your hard work. See, after 2017, the mode of test paper went online. It is very much essential that before taking the real test, you practice the test papers given to you. This is the only way you can clear the exam. The interface of previous was a basic one. This time the test is carrying negative marking. 4 marks will be awarded for every right answer and 1 mark will be deducted for every wrong question. Do not be afraid of committing mistakes. Your mistakes will improve you in improving your performance. Rest assured, nobody is going to judge you for your mistakes. So let me give you a quick tutorial about how you shall take the test. Please watch it carefully. So here I am at the web page and I have already copied the link which I have shared with you on YouTube. So let me paste the link over here and then I will press enter. And then I would be navigated to DU LL.M entrance test 2014. There you have to fill your name, your email to start the exam. So it is very much essential that before starting the exam you fill your name, like I am typing my name over here, and also read the instructions carefully before attempting any question. So I have typed my email ID over here and then click on start. Just wait for some time and then a new page is opened where questions appeared on the screen. So suppose if you do not want to attempt this question and you want to jump back to other questions, so here this is the tab you shall press. So here I'm clicking on it and then a new page opens where I have shown all the answers, all the questions which I could attempt according to my wish. So in that case I'm selecting question number 175, and so I'm navigated to question number 175. And before submitting the question you also have the option to mark it for review. Before submission you can also review the questions, like if you want to change your answer you can definitely do so. So here I am choosing option number 1 and then you have to select submit my answers. And then yes, a new page again opened where I am asked that whether I want to review and make final submissions. So these are the questions that I haven't attempted. So first let the page load properly. Okay, so I want to submit my answer. So here you need to click on this tab and then they are asking that these questions, because I haven't attempted it. So they are asking that whether you want to attempt it or not, or you want to directly submit it. So I would press submit. So now my answer is submitting and just wait. So here I am given the certificate of appreciation. Whosoever will submit their test will be given a certificate of appreciation where your name and your score would be shown in that certificate. So you can also analyze your answers here. All the details are given, like how many questions I have attempted, and do remember the passing grade is 70%. So you need to score at least 70% to pass, and negative marking is -1. And here I'm given that I have only one incorrect answer. So like after submission of all the answers, you will be given the correct answer in the last, after submission of the test. So that's it, that's what you have to do. I hope you all understood the tutorial well. Do not forget to submit your test. I will definitely take the name of all persons who would submit the test. So without wasting time, let us start the session with our first question. Question number 1. Which one of the following make an agreement void? The correct option is option number D, mistake of fact by both the parties. It is given in section 20 of Indian Contract Act, which deals with agreement void where both parties are under mistake as to a matter of fact. Question number 2. Which of the following pairs is incorrect? So the correct option is option number A, rebus sic stantibus. The real meaning of rebus sic stantibus, it is actually a legal doctrine which allows for a contract or a treaty to become inapplicable because of a fundamental change of circumstances. Question number 3. In which one of the following cases general principles of law recognized by civilized nations was applied? Correct option is option number C, Islands of Palmas case 1928. Recognition of government is unnecessary is also known as. It is known as Estrada Doctrine. Option number A. In which of the following cases the issue of right of innocent passage was decided by the International Court of Justice? Option number B, Corfu Channel case. In North Sea Continental Shelf cases, the ICJ held that the equidistance method is not obligatory for the delimitation of the areas. Question number 6. Can a receiving state declare any member of the diplomatic staff of the sending state as persona non grata under Vienna Convention on Diplomatic Relations 1961? The correct option is option number A. Yes, no reasons are to be given for doing so. Question number 7. Which of the following is correct? So the correct option is option number B, Anglo-Norwegian fisheries case. It dealt with delimitation of territorial sea. Let's see about the other options. La Grande case 2001, it dealt with Vienna Convention on Consular Relations. Notebom case is a case concerning nationality, and Nicaragua versus United States, it's a case concerning use of force. Question number 8. Which of the following statement is correct about Hugo Grotius? The correct option is option number D. All the other options are wrong. It is given that he was a positivist, but in real he belongs to natural law school. Question number 9. Who gave the concept of common heritage of mankind for seabed and the ocean floor beyond national jurisdiction? Option number C, Arvid Pardo. 10. Who amongst the following was of the opinion that binding force of international law is based on a fundamental principle known as pacta sunt servanda? Option number A, Angelotti. 11. Nemo judex in causa sua was applied as a general principles of law recognized by civilized nations in. So it is applied in option number B, Georgia factory case 1927. UN Administrative Tribunal case, it's a case concerning the effect of awards of compensation made by the United Nations Administrative Tribunal. 12. Which of the following has not been dealt with by the four Geneva Conventions of 1958 on various zones of the sea? This option number D, exclusive economic zone.
13. Who considered customary international law as a part of common law? Option number B, William Blackstone. 14. Which of the following statements is correct in the light of Article 38, Clause 1 of Statute of International Court of Justice? Option number A, teachings of the most highly qualified publicists is a secondary source of international law. 15. Which of the following statement is known as disputes arising out of contract shall be referred to municipal courts of state which grants concession? This is option number C, Calvo clause, just cogens. It actually means peremptory norms. 16. Which of the following has been dealt with specifically by the agreement of 1994 relating to the implementation of part 11 of the UN Convention on Law of the Sea? This is option number B, seabed mining. 17. Which of the following treaties provides for the rights of individuals to petition to the Human Rights Committee? Option number B, first optional protocol to the International Covenant on Civil and Political Rights. 18. The disputes relating to the compulsory jurisdiction of ICJ on states is decided by. So it is decided by option number C, International Court of Justice. 19. The continental shelf of a state may at the maximum extend up to. So it may extend up to option number C, 350 nautical miles from the baseline, and this is given under Article 17 of UN Charter. 20th. According to UN Convention on Law of the Sea, the coastal state shall give the landlocked states access to surplus of the allowable catch in. Option number C, exclusive economic zone. 21st. If a party to dispute fails to perform its obligations under the decision of International Court of Justice, the other party may have recourse to. So he may have recourse to option number A, Security Council. 22. Continental margin of a coastal state means. So it means shelf plus slope plus rise. Option number B. 23rd. The rule requires that local remedies shall have been exhausted before an international action can be brought. This local remedies include not only reference to the courts and tribunals, but also the use of the procedural facilities which municipal law makes available to litigants before such courts and tribunals. In which of the following cases the above observation was made? This is option number A, M. Batilos arbitration. This is a case concerning between Greece versus UK, and citation is given after. 24. Who was not a supporter of constructive theory of recognition? Option number D, Kunch. 25. According to Article 51A of the Constitution, which among the following are correct? So the correct option is option number B, 2 and 4 only. It shall be the duty of every citizen of India to uphold and protect the sovereignty, unity and integrity of India. And option number 4, it shall be the duty of every citizen of India to develop the scientific temper, humanism and the spirit of inquiry and reform. 26. Article 368 clause 2 reads, an amendment of this constitution may be initiated only by the introduction of a bill for the purpose in A dash. When the bill is passed in B dash, it shall be presented to the president, who shall give his assent to the bill, and thereupon the constitution shall stand amended in accordance with the terms of the bill. So, fill in the blanks question, and I have to choose the correct option from the following. The correct option is option number A. In blank A, it will come either House of Parliament, and in blank B, it will come each house by a majority of the total membership of that house and by majority of not less than 2/3 of the members of that house present and voting. 27. Which part of the constitution was adopted last by the Constituent Assembly? The correct option is option number A, the preamble. 28. The president's resignation has to be address to the dash A, who shall forthwith communicate the same to the dash B. So correct option is option number D. In dash A, vice president will come, and in dash B, speaker of the house of the people will come. And this is given under article 56 of the constitution. 29. According to the constitution of India, the seat of the Supreme Court. So the seat of the Supreme Court will be in option number C, may also be in such other place or places as the Chief Justice of India may, with the approval of the President, from time to time appoint, and this is given under Article 130. 30th. Article 19 gets suspended automatically on the proclamation of emergency on the ground of proclamation is option number B, war of external aggression. 31st. According to Constitution of India, any law made by the Parliament during the proclamation of President's rule under Article 356, option number A, shall continue to be in force until altered or repealed or amended by a competent legislation. 32. The fundamental right enshrined under Article 19, Clause 1, Clause F was omitted by, so it was omitted by option number D, 44th Amendment. Article 19, 1F dealt with right to property. 33. Article 14 is conferred on. So it is conferred on option number B, natural and juristic persons. 34. In which case did the Supreme Court observe that equality of opportunity admits discrimination with reason and prohibits discrimination without reason? So it was held by Supreme Court in option number A, State of Kerala versus Adam Thomas. Air India versus Nargesh Mirza, it's a case concerning conditions of service discrimination. Ajay Hasia versus Khalid Mujib, the case concerns with definition of state. And Anwar Ali Sarkar versus State of West Bengal, the case is relating to Article 14. 35. If any question as to the age of a judge of a high court, it shall be decided by, so it shall be decided by option number C, the President of India after consultation with the Chief Justice of India. 36. If the President of India is to be impeached for violation of the Constitution, the charge shall be preferred by. So the charge shall be preferred by option number C, either House of Parliament, and the procedure for impeachment of President is given under Article 61. 37. The Speaker of the Lok Sabha can resign his office by addressing his resignation to option number D, the Deputy Speaker. 38. Point out the incorrect match. So the correct option is option number B, KC Gajapati Narayan Dev versus State of Odisha. The case actually concerns with doctrine of colorable legislation. 39. All civil and judicial authorities in the territory of India shall act in aid of the Supreme Court has been prescribed under. So it has been prescribed under Article 144. So let's see about the other articles. Article 132 deals with appellate jurisdiction of Supreme Court in appeals from high courts in certain cases. Article 135 deals with jurisdiction and powers of the federal court under existing law to be exercisable by the Supreme Court. Article 261 deals with public acts, records and judicial proceedings. Full faith and credit shall be given throughout the territory of India to public acts, records and judicial proceedings of the Union and of every state. 40. The judge of the Supreme Court is appointed. So it is appointed by option number C, by President after consulting the Union Council of Ministers. The correct option is option number B, by President after consulting the collegium of four judges and the Chief Justice of India. Kindly excuse my mistake. The correct option will be option number B. Kindly correct yourself. 41. Point out the incorrect pair. So the incorrect pair is option number A, Article 83 actually deals with duration of Houses of Parliament. Let's see about the other articles. Article 137 deals with SC, Supreme Court's power of review. Article 256 deals with power of union to issue directions. Article 317 deals with removal and suspension of a member of a public service commission. 42. Which of the following statement is correct? So the correct statement is option number B. No person can waive his fundamental rights under the Indian Constitution as they are sacrosanct, and no individual can tinker with them. 43. Catch-up rule evolved by the Supreme Court in Union of India versus Veer Pal Singh was eliminated by which amendment of the Constitution? So it was eliminated by option number C, 85th Amendment. So let's see about the 85th Amendment, what it actually dealt with. Parliament negated the catch-up rule that the court had introduced in Veer Pal Singh and Ajit Singh. In the 85th Amendment, Parliament amended Article 60, Clause 4A and introduced the principle of consequential seniority to promoted SC/ST candidates. So, in this by that amendment, the catch-up rule was totally negated, which was introduced in Veer Pal Singh case. 44. Under which of the following two provisions the President has to act not on the advice of the Union Council of Ministers but on the advice of some other constitutional authorities? So the correct option is option number C, Article 356 and Article 103 clause 1 and 217 clause 2, option number C, not option number B. I'm sorry, I apologize for my mistake. 103 deals with decision on questions as to disqualifications of members, and 217 deals with appointment and conditions of the office of a judge of a high court. 45. Under the Constitution, doctrine of eclipse applies. So it applies to option number B, to all laws pre-constitutional and post-constitutional. 46. Right to life doesn't include right to die. It has been held in Gyan Kaur versus State of Punjab. 47. Hans Kelsen enjoys the credit of formulating option number A, pure theory of law. 48. Which statement below is the least likely to follow logically from Savigny's notion of a Vulgist? Option number C, law is hugely influenced by religion. 49. May's famous aphorism that the movement of progressive societies has hitherto been a movement from status to contract is often misunderstood. In what way? So it is misunderstood it is misinterpreted as a prediction, which is given in option number B. 50. Which of the following correlatives contradict Hofield's scheme of jural relation? Option number D, immunity and misery. There should be immunity and disability. 51. To which of the following jurisprudential approaches, schools of thought, does the work of John Rawls could best be described to fall in? So it is option number B, liberal positivism. 52. What is natural law? So the correct answer is option number B, law that is derived from higher aspirational principle and values. 53. The Dash School of Jurisprudence postulate that the law is based on what is correct. It is option number A, natural law. 54. According to one of the theories of punishment, evil should be written by evil. This is known as the retributive theory, option number B. 55. The most important instrument of legal reform is option number A, legislation. 56. Animus possidendi means, so it means option number C, intent to exclude others from interference in possession. 57. Who among the following jurists had defined ownership as a right over a determinate thing, indefinite in time in point of user, unrestricted in point of disposition and unlimited in point of duration? This is option number A, Austin. 58. The fault of the historical school of jurisprudence lies in, so it lies in option number D, identifying custom with law itself. 59. Which one of the following statement is true? This is option number D, the method of Austin was not borrowed from anywhere but was of English origin.
60. I have right to do as I please. The term right in this statement refers to. So it refers to option number C, liberty. 61. The rule of social engineering was propounded by. So it was propounded by option number A, Roscoe Pound. 62. The basis hypothesis given by Kelsen is option number B, Grundnorm. 63. Negligence is not a particular state of mind but it's a particular kind of conduct. This is known as option number B, objective theory of negligence. 64. If a norm is for long disregarded in practice and the courts no longer follow it in deciding cases, such a disuse of norms is called as. So such a disuse of norms is called as option number A, desuetude. 65. The corpus of law was classified by Austin, which is the odd one out. Option number D, law by metaphysics. 66. What is Blackstonian doctrine? Option number A, customary international law is part of common law. 67. Who propounded the theory justice as fairness? This is option number A, Rawls. 68. The notion of distributive justice was conceived by. So it is conceived by option number B, Aristotle. 69. The thesis taking right seriously was written by option number B, Ronald Dworkin. 70. The codified Roman law is known as. So it is known as option number C, corpus juris. 71. Duckworth's most important contribution to the field of jurisprudence is the concept of. So it is a concept of social solidarity, option number D. 72. Law is reason free from all passion. This was said by Aristotle, option number B. 73. The political theory of separation of powers between legislature, executive and judiciary was given by option number D, Montesquieu. 74. Which of the following acts invites tortious liability and is not saved by the doctrine voluntary non fit injuria? The correct option is option number B, injury is caused while play fighting with the naked swords at a religious function. 75. Right of divorce to a wife under section 13 clause 2 of Hindu Marriage Act 1955 is available to the wife. Option number B, if the offense of rape, sodomy or bestiality is subsequent to the marriage of the petitioner. 76. A major portion of the Constitution of India is derived from the. Option number C, Government of India Act 1935. 77. Which schedule of the Constitution makes special provisions for the administration and control of scheduled areas and scheduled tribes? Correct option is option number B, 5th schedule. Let's see about the other schedule. 4th schedule deals with allocation of seats in the Rajya Sabha, which is the upper house of parliament per state or union territory. 6th schedule deals with provisions as to the administration of tribunal areas in the states of Assam, Meghalaya, Tripura and Mizoram. And 11th schedule deals with panchayats. 78. The power to determine the number of judges in a high court lies with the. So it lies with the President of India. 79. Which one of the following is not a constitutional body? Option number B, Planning Commission. 80. Libel is addressed to the eye, slander to the ear. State which of the following statements amount to libel? The correct option is option number actually it's a wrong question. The correct answer should be A and C. Words uttered by the characters on the cinema screen and words uttered by the characters on the dramatic stage. So I'm also giving you the explanation about why I should think that option A and C will be the correct answer. See, libel and slander are two types of defamation. That is, false communication regarding someone's reputation. Libel is publication against someone's reputation and can be in the form of photos, videos, cartoons, films, CDs, etc. Like in this case, and hence is said to be addressed to the eye.
On the other hand, slander is a statement in a temporary form and can take a form of spoken words or even gestures, and therefore is said to be addressed to the ears. So that is the reason why I believe that A and C will be the correct answer. 81. In which of the following situations is communication treated as published and defamatory? Option number D, 1 and 4. Dictating a letter to one's typist containing defamatory content about another. And 4. When a libelous letter addressed to the plaintiff is in the ordinary course of business opened by his clerk. 82. X, a fruit dealer, gives his agent Y a van for the supply of fruits to the customers. Y goes for free ride with his friend Z and commits an accident resulting in an injury to A. Which one of the following is correct? Option number B, Y is liable. 83. The ILC draft code of responsibility of states for internationally wrongful acts of 2001 lays down dash as a form of preparation for the injury caused by internationally wrongful act. Option number A, satisfaction. 84. AVM dies describes power coupled with the duty to exercise that power as. So it is known as ministerial power. Option number C. 85. Hans Kelsen talked about. It talked about option number C, validity and effectiveness of norms. 86. In the Indian context, as wrongful act in order to be a crime must be. So the question is actually scrap. This is the wrong question. None of these are the correct answer. 87. How significant is motive in determining the criminal liability of an accused? This is option number D, depends upon the facts and circumstances of every case. 88. In criminal trials, whenever an accused pleads that his case is covered under any of the general exceptions laid down under part 4 of the IPC, the burden of proof lies on option number C. The burden of proof always lies on the accused, and he has to prove his innocence on a preponderance of probabilities. 89. Which of the following is not available as a defense in criminal acts? This is option number D, mistake of law. 90. A person who assists a criminal after the commission of the crime with a view to shield him from the arm of law is known as. So it is known as accessory after the fact. Option number B. The term 91st. The term dishonestly as defined under section 24 of the IPC implies. So it implies an act done with the intention of causing wrongful gain to one person or wrongful loss to another. Option number A. 92. P instigates Q to instigate R to kill S. Q instigates R and R kills S. What is P liable for? The question is actually scrapped because this is not the correct option. The correct option is they would be liable for murder. And this example is given under section 108 of IPC, which deals with abettor. 93. Which of the following offences is punishable at the stage of preparation itself? Dacoity, option number C. 94. Failure to record FIR in case of offences affecting the modesty and dignity of women are punishable under. So it is punishable under section 166A of the IPC. So let's see about the other section. Section 154 of the IPC. 154 of the IPC actually deals with FIR. Sorry about the wrong explanation. Kindly avoid the explanation which is attached to section 154. 157 deals with procedure for investigation, preliminary inquiry. And 165A of the IPC is actually repealed after the enactment of Prevention of Corruption Act 1988. 95. Disclosure of the identity of rape victims has been expressly barred from disclosure under which section of the Indian Penal Code 1860? So this is option number B, section 228A. Section 376E deals with punishment for repeat offenders. 229A, failure by person released on bail or bond to appear in court, section 166B, deals with punishment for non-treatment of victim. 96. Section 164 of the CRPC provides a procedure for recording of. So it provides the procedure of recording for both B and C, confessions and statements. 97. Whoever destroys or moves any landmark fixed by the authority of a public servant shall be held guilty of. So he shall be held, he should be held guilty for mischief under section 434 of IPC. 98. For an offence punishable with fine only, the period of limitation prescribed under section 468 of the CRPC is option number B, 6 months. 99. Under section 73 of the IPC, the maximum time for which a person may be kept in solitary confinement is option number B, 3 months. 100. Use of violence by a member of assembly consisting of 20 persons in furtherance of their common object will constitute. It will constitute rioting, option number C. 101. A husband beat his wife due to which she left the home saying that she would jump into a well. She tried to jump into the village well but a passerby caught her before she could jump. She would be guilty of. So she would be guilty of attempt to commit suicide. So the question was asked in the year 2014 and at that time attempt to commit suicide was punishable, but this is not the case presently. 102. A and B agreed to kill C by giving him a soft drink laced with poison. But before they could do so, they are apprehended. They would be guilty of. So they would be guilty of criminal conspiracy in option number C. 103. Raghu is fond of fast driving and often goes on long drives at fast speed in the early hours of morning when there is less traffic on the roads. One morning he sees a large group of school children assembled outside the school at 5 a.m. in the morning as they were to be taken on a school trip. He doesn't slow down his car and drives through that group, thereby killing a child and injuring several others. He is guilty of. So he shall be guilty of murder. 104. In a criminal trial, during examination chief or re-examination leading questions, option number C will be the correct option and this is given in section 142 of Evidence Act. So leading questions can be asked for certain matters but only with the permission of the court. 105. Under section 98 of the IPC, the right of private defense is also available against. So it is available against all of the above, option number D, against person of unsound mind, against an intoxicated person, against a person who doesn't have maturity of understanding. 106. Which of the following persons are not exempted from criminal prosecution under the provisions of the IPC 1860? So the correct option is option number D, none of the above. Because even President of India could also be prosecuted for any criminal case, but not during when he is holding the office. 107. A and B were sworn enemies in school. A had pushed B due to which he fell down and his two front teeth were knocked out. B was looking for an opportunity to settle scores and once after school he challenged A to a duel and gave him punch on his face with intent to knock out his teeth. But he missed the aim. The blow landed on the right eye of A due to which he lost his eyesight in the right eye. Here B would be held liable for. So he would be liable for voluntary causing grievous hurt, option number B. 108. Z causes the death of A with a very blunt object. According to post-mortem report, multiple injuries were on the non-vital parts of the body and none of these injuries were sufficient in the ordinary course of nature to cause death. However, cumulatively, they were sufficient to cause death. What offense has Z committed? So Z has committed the offense of murder, option number A. 109. A is at work with a hatchet. The head flies off and kills a man who is standing nearby. If A has exercised proper caution, what is the offense that he has committed? So he has committed no offense because it is actually an accident, which is given under section 80 of Indian Penal Code. 110. Z got involved in an accident and dies. A, who was part of rescue team, took the wallet out of his dead body and kept all money in his possession and eventually spent it. What offense, if any, has he committed? So he has actually done the crime of dishonest misappropriation in option number D. 111. A slipped into a pit filled with rainwater. While slipping, he caught hold of a nearby electricity pole to avert the fall. Due to leakage of electricity in the pole, he was electrocuted. Can the electricity board be held responsible? The option, the correct option is option number B, yes. It is a duty of electricity board to take care that there is no leakage of electricity in the pole. This is a case relating to negligence. 112. Innuendo means. Innuendo means is given in option number A, an innocent looking statement which has a hidden defamatory meaning. 113. A, though involved in a motor accident, remained physically unhurt but suffered myoclonic encephalomyelitis, a psychiatric illness with which he had earlier suffered but which was then in remission. He claimed damages from the driver of the motor car. Will he succeed? Correct option is option number D, yes. Though this illness was not foreseeable but some physical harm was foreseeable. The same question is asked in the previous year of 2015. I have already dealt with that session. Kindly go to the playlist and find the video. 114. The Supreme Court brought services provided by medical professionals within the ambit of Consumer Protection Act 1986 in the case of. The correct option is option number B, Indian Medical Association versus VP Shanta. 115. A, who was about to compete in a rally, in a car rally, asked his friend B to drive A's car from Delhi to Chandigarh so as to meet A there at the end of the rally. A was to bring in the car a suitcase for A, and after the rally, they both were to take the car and go to Shimla. B departed from Delhi but before reaching Chandigarh negligently collided with C's car which was damaged. C claimed damages from A and B. So whether both are liable or not, the correct option is option number B. Both A and B can be held liable as A was using the car of A's purpose. 116. A woman was alighting from a tram car when a speeding reckless motorcyclist collided with a motor car little away in the center of the road. In that collision, the negligent motorcyclist was killed on the spot. The woman heard the bang and saw the blood on the road, thought not the body of the injured man. She was in an advanced stage of pregnancy. Due to the nervous shock sustained by her, she gave birth to a stillborn baby. C sued the representatives of the motorcyclist to recover damages. Which one of the following propositions is correct in a leading case? Option number C. She cannot recover damages as a deceased owed no duty of care towards the woman though he was negligent towards the... The correct option will be option number A, not option number C. By mistake, I have given here option number C. She can recover damages as a deceased owed duty of care towards her. 117. A railway company was authorized by law to run railway trains on a track. The sparks from the engine set fire to the adjoining property belonging to the plaintiff. Which one of the following defenses will be most appropriate for the defendant to raise in action for nuisance by the plaintiff? The correct option is option number B, D, or statutory authority. 118. For a person to succeed in a suit for malicious prosecution, which combination from the five factors must be proved? The correct option is option number D, 2, 3, and 5. Prosecution has ended in favor of plaintiff. And presence of malice and prosecution was without reasonable cause. Do one thing, I have told you to take option number A as a correct answer. But you can also go with option number C. As the man who was involved in the accident was died on the spot. So in that case, the correct option will be option number C. In the test paper also, you are free to tick the option number C. And I have taken the options, I mean the correct options from the answer key of DULLM test 2014. So you need not worry, you can go with option number C. 119. Defense of absolute privilege is available in which of the following cases? So absolute privilege is available in the cases of 1, 2 and 3. Publication of proceedings in parliament, publication of proceedings in a court and publication of a report of the proceedings in parliament. Option number A, 1, 2 and 3. 120. The rule laid down in re polemis case is that the defendant shall be liable for all. So in re polemis case, it is held that the direct consequences of the respondent shall be responsible if he could foresee some damage to the plaintiff from his act. Correct option is option number B. 121. Which of the following statement is incorrect? The correct option is option number D. None of the above is incorrect. The general rule that employer is not liable for tort committed by the independent contractor is not applicable in cases of strict liability. Totally correct. Sabotage is a defense in cases of strict liability. Okay. The rule of absolute liability doesn't require escape of dangerous thing from defendants. This is also correct. 122. Which of the following is not correctly matched? So the correct option is option number B, act of God, Smith versus Charles Baker. And all the other options are totally correct. 123. Which one of the following defenses did the defendants in the case of Donog versus Stevenson not plead? So this option number B, C, the incident could not be prevented by the standard of foresight of the reasonable man. This is not the defenses which was taken by the defendant in the case of Donog versus Stevenson. 124. Which one of the following statements illustrates the principle of contributory negligence? This is option number A. The plaintiff by his own want of care contributes to the damage caused by the negligence or wrongful conduct of the defendant. 125. Select the essential elements for the defense of fair comment in tort of defamation from the following and indicate the correct answer in the quotes given below the elements. The matter commented on must be. This is option number B, 1, 3 and 4. Of public interest and expression of opinion and it should be fair. 126. Which of the following defenses in an action for tort or nuisance are non-effective defenses? This is option number C, 1, 3 and 4. Public good, third option is nuisance due to acts of others, and four, reasonable care. 127. The Supreme Court laid down in Dash that where the enterprise is engaged in hazardous or inherently dangerous activities and harm result to anyone on account of accident, the enterprise is strictly liable to compensate all those who are affected by such accident. This is option number B. M.C. Mehta versus Union of India. 128. In which of the following cases did the Supreme Court of India give a ruling that sovereignty immunity of the state is subject to fundamental rights? This is option number D. People's Democratic Union for Democracy versus State of Bihar. 129. Under the Consumer Protection Act 1986, a complaint has to be filed in consumer forum within. So it has to be filed within 2 years from the date on which the cause of action has arisen. This is option number D. 130. An appeal against an order made by the National Consumer Dispute Redressal Commission lie to. So it lies to the Supreme Court. 131. Under the Consumer Protection Act 1986, service include service of any description which is made available to a potential user. So this is option number B, under a contract for personal service, and this is given under section 2 clause 42. See, the questions and answers, the answers may vary for the present times, as the questions were asked in the year 2014, as I have already mentioned it. So you may find varying answers. So kindly correct yourself that the answers were of the year 2014, not of presently. I am just giving you for the sake of information. 132. Which of the following disputes cannot be raised before the consumer forum? This option number A, a dispute relating to service conditions or retirement benefits of a government servant. 133. If a person is a victim of an offence under IPC and such offence is also a tort, for example, in the case of defamation, negligence, nuisance, etc., such a person can seek remedies through both A and B, civil suit for compensation under law of torts only, and criminal cases for fixing the criminal liability on the accused under the IPC only. 134. Degrees of prohibited relationship include relationship by all of these: full blood, half odd, uterine blood, and adoption. 135. Propositions are, they're asking that which of the proposition is correct and which are incorrect. The correct option is option number B. 2 and 3 are correct and 1 is incorrect. Say, a void marriage remains valid until a decree annulling it has been passed by a competent court. In cases of void marriages, no decree for annulling it is required for making it invalid. 136. A decree of nullity of marriage in case of voidable marriages annuls the marriage. So it annuls a marriage from the date of marriage. 137. Section 18 of Hindu Marriage Act 1955 prescribes punishment. So it prescribes punishment for all of the above: for child marriage, for marriage between sapindas, for marriage between persons falling within the degrees of prohibited relationship, and all of the that means all of the above. 138. A child born out of void marriage. So, child out of void marriage, the question is actually scrapped. The correct answer would be none of this. So, this is given in section 16 clause 3, because a child which is born out of a void marriage can only acquire the interest of property to his parents and cannot acquire any interest in the co-parsonary property. 139. Withdrawal from the society of other within the meaning of section 9 of the Hindu Marriage Act means both A and B, refusal to have sexual intercourse, and B, total repudiation of cohabitation. 140. During judicial separation, the option number A, parties continue to be husband and wife, but marital rights and obligations are suspended. 141. Which of the following is incorrect regarding desertion as a ground for divorce? The correct option is option number D. The statutory period of 1 year must have run out before a petition is presented. Yeah, this is the incorrect answer, because desertion should be for a total period of 2 years. 142. The bar to entertain a petition for divorce operates for a period of. So it operates for a period of, the correct option is option number C, 1 year from the date of the marriage. So this is given under section 14, no petition for divorce to be presented within 1 year of marriage. But however, in emergency situations, even the petition could be filed before the expiry of 1 year. 143. In proceedings for dissolution of marriage by mutual consent under section 13B of the Hindu Marriage Act 1955, the parties have to move the court once again. Option number B, after 6 months, but before 18 months from the date of presenting the petition. 144. Order of permanent alimony under section 25 of Hindu Marriage Act 1955 can be varied, modified, or rescinded. Option number D. All of the above. So, in which cases the order of permanent alimony can be varied, modified, or rescinded? Like, if the party in whose favor the order has been passed remarries, If the party in whose favor the order has been passed is wife, she has not remained chaste. If the party in whose favor the order has been passed is a husband and he has sexual intercourse with any other woman. 145. Section 28 of Hindu Marriage Act 1955 provides for. So this question is also scrapped. So the correct answer will be appeals from decrees and orders, and which is not given in the option. 146. State the new right to wife to file a petition before the district court within local limits of whose jurisdiction. So correct option is option number A. She is residing on the date of presentation of the petition. This is given in section 126 of CRPC. 147. Every appeal from decrees or orders under section 28 of Hindu Marriage Act 1955 shall be preferred after 2003 within a period of. So it should be filed within a period of 90 days from the date of decree of order, option number A. 148. Conversion of Muslim wife to a faith other than Islam, option number A, shall not by itself operate to dissolve her Muslim marriage, and it is given under section 4 of Dissolution of Muslim Marriage Act 1939. 149. Which one of the following is not a ground for divorce provided by the Hindu Marriage Act 1955? This is option number B, imprisonment of the respondent for a period of 4 years. This is not given under Hindu Marriage Act 1955. 150. A born Muslim girl brought up by a Hindu family married a Hindu boy as per Shastric ceremonies. The marriage is. So the marriage is invalid, option number B. 151. Ramesh and Rani file a joint petition for a decree of divorce by mutual consent under the Hindu Marriage Act 1955. 6 months later, second motion was filed by Ramesh alone as Rani refused to join him. Option number 1. In this case, divorce will not be granted to Ramesh. 152. A Muslim wife's right to dower can be claimed as. So it can be claimed as option number B, an ordinary unsecured debt along with other creditors. 153. As per the Hindu Marriage Act 1955, Sagotra marriage is. It is perfectly valid, option number B. 154. Which of the following enactments provides for grounds of divorce made available to wife alone? So only the Dissolution of Muslim Marriage Act 1939 provides for divorce for the grounds which is only available to a Muslim wife, option number A. 155. In which one of the following cases the Delhi High Court held that pronouncement of talaq 3 times by a Muslim husband results in single talaq only? This is option number B, Masroor Ahmad case. 156. The Muslim Woman Protection of Rights on Divorce Act 1986 deals with. So it deals with option number A, maintenance rights of divorced Muslim women. 157. Which one of the following grounds is not available to Hindu and Muslim wives both to claim divorce? This is option number A, husband renounce the world by entering any religious order. This ground is not available to both Hindu as well as Muslim wife for divorcing her husband. 158. Ramesh intentionally pulls up a woman's veil without her consent, intending or knowing it to be likely that he may thereby injure, threaten or annoy her. He has committed the offense as option number B, criminal force. 159. In states where compulsory registration of marriage is required, non-registration of marriage will, it will not affect the validity of marriage, option number B. 160. Every promise and every set of promises forming the consideration of each other is called as an agreement. This is option number C. 161. An acceptance containing additions, limitations or other modifications shall amount to. So it shall amount to both A and C. Rejection of the offer and a counter offer. 162. Inadequacy of consideration is relevant in determining the question of option number C, free consent. 163. In a contract no specifying the time for performance, the promisor can perform the contract, option number C, then it should be performed within a reasonable time. 164. Which one of the following statement is true? offer and acceptance are revocable? Yes, this is two, option number A. 165. Lending money to a borrower at high rate of interest when the money market is tight renders the agreement of loan totally valid, option number B. 166. The basic of action under the remedy of quantum meriit is, so the quantum of the remedy of quantum meriit is restitution, option number A. 167. A contract doesn't stand discharged, option number D, by a mere delay in performance. 168. The juridical basis of quasi-contractual obligation can be explained by the theory of, so it can be explained by the theory of unjust enrichment. 169. In cases of joint promise, generally a promisor can compel, option number D, all of the above. So the joint, in the joint promise, the promisor can compel all of them, like all the joint promisers to perform, yeah, any one of them to perform, some of them to perform. So it is his wish, like whom he wants to perform the promise. 170. Under section 75 Indian Contract Act, the court award damages, option number C, more than the amount stipulated in the contract. 171. When there is a breach of contract, special damages are awarded. So special damages are awarded in option number D, when only when there is a notice of the likely special loss. 172. Breach of contract may be, so breach of contract may be actual or anticipatory, option number C. 173. A tradesman leaves goods at B's house by mistake. B treats the goods at his own. Which one of the following remedies is available to A? So the cut off is option number B. B is bound to pay A for goods. 174. Where A, a tenant, pays a property tax on behalf of owner B, who is bound to pay it? A is. So A is, option number 1, entitled to be reimbursed by B. 175. A pays rupees 10,000 to B for manufacturing a machine. When it is partly manufactured, the contract is discharged by frustration. What is the remedy available to parties? So the correct option is option number D. B is entitled only to expenses incurred before the time of discharge. This is an example of frustration of contract, which is given under section 56 of Indian Contract Act, which in word says agreement to do impossible act. So this is the end of the session. I hope you all like the session. Do not forget to like, share and subscribe the channel to get all such notifications. Also, do not forget to submit the test. So, with this note, I am signing off. Have a great day.